Okay, this week we're talking about Play-Doh. Why Play-Doh? Well, aside from being tons of fun, Play-Doh can actually be really good for going in and setting up the intake manifold and all this stuff inside a car. Now, for instance, our 351 Windsor. A, this car never came with a 351 Windsor. B, we have a very tall air cleaner on this. And while I like the look of that air cleaner, I'm a little suspicious about what we may have going on with the relationship to the height of the air cleaner and our hood. So what we're going to do now is we're going to actually use Mr. and Mrs. Play-Doh to go in and figure out if we're going to have any kind of problems with striking the hood with either our air cleaner or, let's hope not, the idler on our serpentine belt system. Okay, now I'm gonna drop this hood, but I'm not gonna slam it because slamming it can be a big problem for you with what's going on with your air cleaner or other parts on the car. Best to close it really slowly. If you close it slowly, you have a good chance of being able to catch anything that might be rubbing on the bottom side of the hood. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just gonna slowly drop this hood down and see what we get. Goodbye, Mr. Play-Doh Man. We'll always have Paris. Oh no, that doesn't look good at all for Play-Doh Man. Okay, I'm gonna grab the latch and open it up. Close the hood down. And I don't feel anything that's a problem. So now we're gonna open the hood back up and check for any kind of interference issues. Hey, Mr. Play-Doh didn't do very well. In fact, Mr. Play-Doh did so badly that I'm going to have to take the 3-inch air cleaner out of here and put a 2.5-inch in. Now, Mrs. Play-Doh, she's a little flat-faced now, but you know, that's plenty of room. You've got a ton on top of this, so you know that you're not going to be striking anything on the underside of the hood up here on the front of the engine dress. Again, just driving that point home. There's good places to use Play-Doh all over the car, and I'm going to show you another one right now. Okay, I'm going to put my fender cover down, and I'm going to pull my valve cover off for my Play-Doh experiment. Now, I've already done this on this, so I know this is going to work, but what I want to do is I'm going to use my Play-Doh, and I've got some plastic wrap here, and I'm going to put the plastic wrap on top of the engine so that I don't get any Play-Doh down inside my beautifully done 351 Windsor. And my focus in this is going to be these two rocker arms right here, because they should run in this valley between this area here. There should be a rocker arm on this side and on this side. And these valve covers typically have a much larger piece. They weren't designed for roller rockers like we're running on this car. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna actually put the Play-Doh on top of the rocker arms. I'm gonna reinstall the valve cover. And I'm doing this without gaskets on the engine as well. And the reason for that is I wanna make sure that I've got enough room, because if I've got enough room without gaskets, I'll have enough room with gaskets. Pull that back off. And you can see that we've made a face. But more importantly, we're not running into anything on the valve cover itself. So that's exactly what we want, giving us plenty of room to do what we need in there so the valve cover can go back on the car. And we're one step closer to getting this 351 Windsor running. So that's our fast break for this week. Y'all have a great week. See you later.